Alright, hey everybody. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to do a retro slash chromatic aberration effect to your text in Photoshop. So I'm using an older version of Photoshop, so some things might be a little outdated, like some of the toolbars and windows and whatnot. But let's just jump into it. So anyways, first I grabbed this basically YouTube channel art template just from Google, and this is just for, of course, YouTube channel art. So I'm gonna be using that just for the background. Starting off, I'm going to just fill it in with white just to have as a backdrop. Sometimes I tried this with white text and a black background, and it didn't really turn out all that well. So yeah, we're gonna do black text. So basically what I'm doing is just going to get my text here. You can really, you know, do whatever font you want. It's probably better to do a bold font, bold typeface, but yeah, we're just gonna put in our text here. So I'll just do that. Let's just try to find a bolder typeface. Let me just use it here. Alright, so this is actually good. Actually, let's do it in uppercase. Alright, so we're going to say okay to that, and we will rasterize this just to start off with. So I'm going to go to right click on this layer and rasterize type. So now what we have is this text, of course. And what we want to do to start off with is we're going to give it some glitch kind of look. So if you've ever seen any VCR videos, especially when you're rewinding them, they have that kind of signature, kind of glitchy look. I'll put it on the screen now. You can see an example of it. But we're going to try to do that with this text here. So basically, we want to kind of follow a not really uniform shape, but at the same time, we want to make them, you know, randomize these you know, alterations in the text. So I took my rectangular marquee tool here, just selected a horizontal bit of the whole text, and going to use the selection tool and just use my arrow keys to move that to the side. So at the top here, I'm just going to move it something like that, and I'm going to take the marquee tool again, and I'm going to zoom in close, and then I'm going to do another bit of the text, just a little narrower, this horizontal section will be a bit narrower, so I'm going to just make that a bit narrower. There we go. Alright, now my selection tool, and I'm going to move that the opposite way. So these can be, as I said, a bit randomized, but at the same time, try to remember that the text or the you know, VCR effect, kind of the bottom of the text is going to be warped to the right, and the top of the text is going to be warped to the left. If you understand what I'm talking about, like let's say you have the text here, a straight line of text. When you add that effect, it would usually end up something like that, or something like that. So what we've done here, I'm going to do a little bit more. Do more narrow one here, and then we got that distortion going on, so that is good. So now what we're going to do is add the chromatic aberration effect. So basically, what we're going to do to start off with is duplicate this layer. So you can do duplicate layer, or you can just do Command J, and we're going to just drag those underneath the main layer. So what we're going to do is start off by double clicking the first duplicate you made, add a color overlay. Oh man, I didn't, what the heck happened there? I don't know. Okay, anyways, we're going to add a blue that's almost cyan, but not quite. So I don't know what the heck this is. I'm just going to give me a second here. Okay, I don't know what the heck happened there. Anyways, so we added that blue kind of look to it, and now we're going to move it over either left or right. I'm going to just move it over to the right. So about, you know, something like that, that far. And then we're going to take the other one and add a... Okay, this one has it as well. This one has it as well. So we're going to add a color overlay to this as well, and it's going to be somewhat red and somewhat pink, almost, not quite pink, but mostly red. So something like that. And we're going to move this to the opposite direction, so left. And that is good. So already you can kind of see the shape or the kind of look we're going for here. And what we're going to do now is we're going to rasterize those layer styles. So just right click and rasterize style. And now we're going to duplicate these as well. So duplicate the ones you just made. So Command J, I'm going to duplicate them about four times, or three times, sorry. So what I'm going to do to these is, actually no, before we duplicate those, we'll take the one duplicated and we're going to move that down to about 25% opacity. And now we're going to duplicate it. And every time we duplicate it, we're going to move it over about five clicks of the arrow keys. Four, five, something like that. And then we're going to duplicate that one more time. So in total, about three, four times, something like that. So that's good. That's what we're going to go for. And we're not going to merge these yet, but we will in a minute. So we're going to do the same with this. Command J, drag that under, 25% opacity. And 1, 2, okay, sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Command J, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Command J, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, there we go. So we have that. And now, what we're going to do is actually take the outside kind of, you know, the ones that we moved all the way over. We're going to recolor them. Sorry about that, guys. Now we're back. Okay. We're going to do hue and saturation. I said color balance, but sorry, I said channel mixer, but it's hue and saturation. Apply to the one layer. We're going to change it to... Okay. So it looks like it's actually going to apply to all the layers. So yeah, as we do work on this bottom layer, it will, you know, affect all the layers above it because of the opacity. So we're going to add that, make it pretty much yellow. We're pretty much going to make the outside layer yellow. So that is what we are going for. That looks good. All good. And now we're going to take the... we can merge those. Not yet. But we're going to take the outermost layer of the blue text. That is the outermost layer. Yep. We're going to add a hue and saturation to that. But for this one, we're going to make it cyan like that. So add pretty much a bunch of green to it. So that's it. That's what we're going for. Boom. All right. So when we got that done... So now you can really see what we're going for. It's really coming together. So at this point, we're going to take all of the blues, merge them. Take all of the reds, merge them. So now we have the chromatic aberration layer. Oh, sorry, of blue and red, which we can turn on and off. And we have the actual text layer. So we're going to take these... chromatic aberration layers. We're going to merge them. All right, we're going to add some motion blur now. So this will blend the layers to make it look a bit more realistic, and it'll give it a, you know, cooler kind of look. So 5, 4. We'll stick with 3. So 3 looks good. As you can see, looks pretty nice. So, if you ever want to go back and change some of the color that we have going on here, like let's say you want to make the red a bit more red, you can go to Channel Mixer, and you can apply to the one layer. Just change your output channel. So let's say you want to make it more red, you want to give it less blue. So you want to put that. You can see that I changed the red. I dragged the red down a bit. I think it looks better with a bit more blue, you know, making it a bit more magenta looking. So I think that's good right there. I think that's nice. We're going to just merge that down. So what we have here is our text with the aberrations and the distortions. So that's looking nice. Now what we're going to do is take the top. Actually, we're going to merge these. We're going to merge them all. So now we have one full layer here. Now what we're going to do is add noise to the whole thing. Oh my goodness, this is still here. I can't believe it. I can't believe it's still here. Delete, she gone. Okay, now we're going to take the whole thing, add noise to it. So something like that. Like about, so I'm going to pick, I think uniform looks a bit better than Gaussian, personally. So we're going to do monochromatic, yep, 35. No, I'm going to say 30%, something like that. So I think that really gives it a good look there. So that is basically how you do that. If you want to go a step further, you can add a kind of screen look almost. Make it look like you're looking at a screen. So I'm going to add a layer here. I'm going to fill this layer with black. Change the opacity down to about 11, something like that. I'm going to actually add some green to that. So there we go, making it look a bit more like you're actually looking through a screen. Do a little less. There we go, that's good. Then I'm going to add another layer. I'm going to get my elliptical marquee tool. Just put that right in between the text, right in the middle of the text. And I'm going to add white. Actually, no, I'm not going to do anything yet. I'm just going to, oops, sorry. Holding shift, I'm going to add this. So just selects the whole upper half of this. I'm going to take my gradient tool. I'm going to hold shift and drag down. Okay, so opacity, going to go all the way up, sorry. Oops. Okay. And now we're going to have this kind of look there. Almost like it's shining on the screen there. And then, sorry, reselect. I'm going to do Control Shift I to invert. And then what I'm going to do is add. Sorry. All right. So what you see I've done is just change the opacity of these layers that I added the gradients to make it kind of look like a screen, like you're looking through an old retro TV screen. All right, we're going to do one more thing just to go even another step further. I'm just going to disable these layers just for the sake of working on this. So what I'm going to do is duplicate this entire layer, put that under, and I'm going to duplicate it once more. I could just do Control J, but whatever. Anyways, I'm going to change the opacity down all the way to about 10% on that one. I'm going to do 5% on that one. So I'm going to move this. I'm going to hold shift, move this all the way over to the right like that. Move this even more so to the right like that. And what I'm going to do is take the first layer. I'm going to warp this just like that. Just to give it a rewind effect as we talked about. So something like that. We'll give that effect, all right? And this one, we can just stretch like that. And now we have our kind of, you know, rewinded look. I'm gonna move this up 1%, or 6%. Yeah, there we go, that looks good. And yeah, there we go. So that is our text. And once we add these layers back, it gives it that effect that it's on the screen almost. And to these, we can even up the opacity a bit more, 14%, 9%. So that looks good. All right, so there you go, guys. That is how you do chromatic aberrations and a VCR effect in Photoshop. See you guys later.